In today's video, we are going to look at strength exercises for hip impingement rehab.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. In the first part of this short series, we covered core exercises proposed by Wall et al. In 2016 for a treatment protocol used in patients with femoroacetabular impingement. Another important area to address in rehab is of course strength, so in this video we will take a look at the recommended strength exercises.
For the first exercise, the patient is asked to lean sideways against a wall standing on their operated leg. They bend the non-affected leg up against the wall in front of them. Then they use the non-affected leg to push against the wall while keeping their balance with the muscles of the operated leg. Secondly, we have the forward lunge. The patient is standing straight and then takes a step forwards and bends their knees. Then they return to the starting position and repeat the same procedure with the other leg. Another great exercise are bridges or bottom lifts. The patient lies on their back with the hip and knees bent and a theraloop around their knees. Then, while keeping tension on the theraloop so as to keep the knees apart, they lift the hips and lower the hips again. You may remember this exercise from the Askling hamstring strain protocol. The patient will stand on one leg with the knee slightly flexed. With the arms to the side for balance, perform a dive forward by flexing at the hip joint, keeping the torso straight. The swinging leg can be bent a little bit. Do this exercise on both legs. Again, as a note, the repetitions and sets should be adjusted to the capacity of the individual patient. As an alternative to the forward lunge, you can perform the three-way lunge. So, lunge forward and back to the starting position and then to the side. You can also include crab walks in the strengthening protocol and optionally use a theraloop to provide resistance. Staying low in the squat position, perform side steps in both directions. Moving on, you can do the gluteal dip. Standing with one leg on a stepper with a straight back, allow the free leg to hang off the edge of the surface. The free leg should dip down below the surface or the stepper 5 to 10 centimeters. Repeat the same procedure on the other leg. At last, there's the side plank. The patient is lying on the side with the elbow of the bottom arm on the floor and the top leg in front of the bottom leg. Then they raise the hips up so that the body forms a straight line. Beware to not let the leg sag down or backwards and hold this position for a couple of seconds.
These are the strength exercises included in the protocol. Check part 3, where we cover the included mobility exercises by clicking or tapping on the left. Please subscribe to our channel if you haven't yet, and make sure you hit the bell icon next to the button to get notified when we post new videos. Check the video description for a handful of useful links, for example, to our other social media channels. And as always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.